its eighth straight week of losses. Is this the start of a sustained comeback? Let's bring in Tom Lee, managing partner at Fundstrat Global Advisors. Tom, is this rally convincing to you?
I would say for anyone who's an investor, there's a lot of bargains out there. I mean, there's so many stocks that have been obliterated in the last 8 weeks. We've been highlighting how companies with faster revenue growth now traded at a discount to companies that actually have negative revenue growth. So there's been more of a investors getting out of positions, not really looking at price. And so I think a lot of stocks are pretty attractive risk reward.
I like how you qualify that if you're an investor, meaning that's a longer term horizon. In the near term, Tom, I'm wondering how you think the markets start digesting this idea of a potential recession. And now creeping to the conversation, there's a talk of stagflation out there. Whether or not you think it's true, and I believe that you're in the boat who thinks that it's not true, it's out there and it's a concern. So how does the market process that? We've seen what's happened in the past 7 weeks for the Dow and the past 8 weeks for the S&P and NASDAQ.
Yes, I mean, it's clear that the central case for investors is the Fed's going to tighten until they achieve what they want, which is, engineering a soft landing. But really what they'd like to see is a demand destruction by either jobs falling or, GDP contracting. And I think the thing that is not really priced and very difficult to price is that a lot of things could go right. I mean, something as simple as labor market could start to ease because you get rebounders, people coming back to the workforce, or the job market weakens, or we could have a real decline in goods prices. Now that we've seen it from these retailers, they have too much inventory. That's actually deflationary. Some supply chains could come back online better than expected, and possibly the war could end. I mean, so I think if you think the cumulative probability of many of these things is much greater than the market's discounting, that means stocks and the Fed could actually be much further along than people realize.
You've been taking a look at the data, Tom, data from Indeed, for instance, and I'm wondering what you see and how you interpret that. There's been some pullback in hiring in certain sectors, which would seem to me like, on the surface, that's bad news. But that's actually what the Fed wants to happen.
Yeah, I actually think the job market's really important to watch. And I think the market and investors and your audience has to be aware the Fed really has to work with some lag data. The JOLTS report that they cite from their May FOMC meeting was with data from March 31. It's always 6 weeks lagged. And that's why our team's been looking at the Indeed data, which is actually updated daily. There's four industries that have accounted for the majority of the rise in job postings. That's retail, leisure, healthcare, and then construction. And as we highlight in our note, if you look at the data since March 31, all four have actually seen a pretty big downturn. In healthcare, it's not because people aren't going to see the doctor. It's just that the staffing required for COVID has drastically declined. So I think the job market could be a lot softer than the Fed has in mind when they say that the JOLTS data shows it's the tightest job market in history. I mean, everything since March 31 shows it's weakened a lot.
Why doesn't that give you pause for concern, Tom, if the job market is softer than we think? I mean, the whole bull, one major pillar of the bull case is that the consumer remains strong, that wages remain strong, the consumer can handle inflationary spikes and periods of inflation because they have better jobs, et cetera. But if we are seeing softness in the job market that perhaps the official data isn't showing, then shouldn't we really be worried? It seems to beg for some sort of adjustment in the market.
Well, it's a good question. It's like, is it a heads I win, tails I lose, or whatever? I think it's what the market's going to care about is monetary policy, because this is really the first time the Fed's using the channel of wealth effect to try to slow the economy, not through tightening credit as much as trying to really hit demand. If the job market weakens, that's going to alleviate the biggest pressure point, which, as Powell said many times, it's the tightest job market in history. So I think if that pressure valve eases, it starts to take a lot of pressure, especially from the market's perspective, about what the Fed has to do. And that's why I think stocks could actually rally pretty substantially. Again, there's many paths for positive outcomes. And I think the central case of this is a tightening until we have a crash, even Jamie Dimon's comments today really address the fact that maybe the market central case is too hawkish.
All right, Tom, we'll see. We'll leave it there. Thank you, Tom Lee, Fundstrat. Always good to see you. After the-